Spread out. Fellas, let's keep this simple. High knees all the way down. High knees, high knees. High knees, high knees.
My name is Ryan Wetzel. I am a personal basketball trainer. I also work in mental health as a suicide prevention coordinator.
Take that knee over, take that knee over.
I get into this little league here in the Bitterroot Valley. We're playing this team. And when the ball went up and I saw him jump, I was like, whoa. Especially when he caught one, it went up two hands and dunked on three guys. It was just like the movie Air Up There, where the guy's like, who is this guy? I felt like that, like Kevin Bacon in that movie, like, who is this guy?
My name's Shad Blair. I work for a company called Garden City Plumbing in Missoula.
I said, hey, you know, what are your thoughts about professional trying out?
I told him, whatever, man, shut up. He says, no, I am 100% serious. You have what it takes. I said, don't just get my emotions worked up on this, because it is something that I've always wanted once I got to the college level. And it was taken away from me, and if you think I can do it, he says, absolutely, I know you can do it.
Ultimately, this last go around with this last tryout, he ends up getting an invite to go down to the Las Vegas Combine, which is the biggest one in the country.
You got time for the bullshit? I'm gonna cut it down, 7 seconds. I want pull-up jumpers.
On the floor, that guy's not 36. He's not. He's 22.
Come on, fellas, y'all gotta make this. Y'all trying to live a dream.
If you stay content long enough, to me, you're gonna start going downhill at some point. If you're always trying to climb up in life, content, there's no room for content.
This is your opportunity. This window cannot come to this event. Spend all this money for you to fuck up. That's just real talk. Either you can play or you don't.
That ends a 14.
I mean, that's just the way it is. A lot of these guys, they just continue to push through and push through, and they got that break and that opportunity.
Look at that. Did you see that?
That was beautiful.
Dion, man. Where is he? He got gray hair and everything.
He caught it and just dunked it.
No step. That's you.
Thing is, and I tell people this all the time, whether it be in recovery from being an alcoholic or anybody, how bad do you want it? Double cross, sell it, good. And with Shad, he's put things on the back burner for so long, and he wants to show the basketball world that he can play. There he is, ready to rock and roll?
Yep.
You look good. You smell good too. Not really.
We lived on a ranch and we all had our chores. We all had to do what we had to do to survive, and they knew it when they were kids. I'm on my third kidney transplant right now. They saw me in the worst stages you could be, with dialysis, laying in the hospital with a kidney failure, and still get out of the hospital and go right back to work. And he'll do it the same way. He'll go until there's no end. He'll go until there's no end.
Come on, come on. This is your ticket, Shad. This is your ticket. Come on, come on. Right to me, right to me. One more, one more. Right there. Yeah.
Daddy clean?
What are you doing?
Nothing. Landon, stop.
Did you do your homework?
We don't have any.
Basketball to me at one point was my life. I was gonna be the biggest thing that ever came out of Montana. I was getting calls from like USC, and I remember thinking, wow, this is big time.
Off the counter and out of that key.
Yeah, get in here.
Is that it?
I'd go in and run. My foot started to go numb. Parents took me into the doctor and discovered that I had extremely high pressure in my calves and diagnosed me with compartment syndrome.
I keep telling Shad to just continue to push through some of the stuff we've been doing.
Are you just bossing him around, or are you actually doing it with him?
Well, no, I'm taking it easy. I have a lot of fun just telling him what to do.
I figured somebody that'll actually listen to you.
Ryan, he was a great basketball player from childhood, and he had the heart for it and the drive for it, and it was taken away from him.
I really tried to push through my pain. I had probably 5 surgeries on it. I just kept going.
Levanna, did you get your jump shots in today?
I ended up getting an invite to go over and pursue my career in Germany and play professional basketball. And it wasn't the great lengthy career as some of these guys, but it was something that, for me, it was an ultimate achievement.
Let's pray. Okay, you ready?
Heavenly Father, thank you for this beautiful day. Thank you for everything you're doing in our lives. And this opportunity with Shad, I lift it up to you. This is a big deal. So thank you so much for everything. In Jesus' name, amen.
Shad grew up in Eureka, and it's unfortunate, but it's the truth. Not a lot of coaches in Montana know how to use 6'10 players. Rarely do you see them. And when you do see them, sometimes they look rough.
Will you grab me a smaller punch that I can reach underneath this thing?
Ends up getting his arm smashed, and he never really got that opportunity at all to really compete at the level I think he can compete.
Put my hand where it shouldn't have been, got it pinned up between a wall and a semi backing up, and blew my wrist apart. I didn't expect it to be 8 years to heal. You know, it's tough once you get in a groove of working and supporting a family and doing that normal routine, and you've already put your wishes and dreams on the back burner. A lot of times it's hard to go back to them.
I know he can do it. I know he can. I don't care how many people doubt him or what I've heard. Oh, I've played against him. He ain't that good. Because you're always going to have somebody in doubt. Always. No matter what.
I love the way this thing makes her feel. She's just happy all the time when that thing's up and running.
Basketball thing. I know he works out more than I've worked out in the last 10 years, probably in a day, you know what I mean? I know how he does it, you know, with a job and his family and working out. That's a lot.
He fits in very well here. He likes all this kind of stuff. I met him when he was 19, and I think I was 21.
But tell us a little bit about this.
51 Diamond Tee. My uncle built it in 89. It's got between $400,000 and $500,000 on it, the way it sits.
When you love someone, you just stick by them and make sure that they make it.
Love to see old stuff running. Heck yeah.
I mean, I've been with him for half his life, so I've been there through all of it. I've been there through the death of his mom, us having a hard time and not being able to get the bills paid, and
care about anything else. I just want him to play because that's what he loves to do. And I love to watch him. And my ultimate goal is to watch him play on TV. Doesn't matter if we sell the house, if we have to move. I want to be a homemaker. I got what I wanted. Why would I not want to help push him to do what he wants to do?
This whole time, and I always throw it out there to him, you know, look, there's this opportunity. Can you do it? Oh, yeah, yeah, I'll look into it, yeah.
Some two-on-one?
No. This whole mortgage thing and his financial situation, they were back on their mortgage, like a couple months. You know, you can't have all these things going on in your life if you're trying to be a professional athlete. You know, you can't, I mean, that stuff is so heavy for a family man. See a pro tryout? You draw the line somewhere.
I don't see him hardly at all. Because I work nights, he works days, and I work weekends. So, it's rough.
One of the big issues is he doesn't like to let people down. That's why I care about that guy so much. He doesn't want to let anybody down.
Gotta make it.
This is hard.
Nice shot.
I see it in his eyes. He's like, I'm gonna do whatever I can to make this happen. And then going into this Vegas one, I could kind of sense he was not really able to afford some things. So he did the fundraiser.
But make it big enough. And then we can just set it right there, and then I'll call Nike and tell them to give you $500,000.
Shad.
Tyler.
Nice to meet you, Tyler.
This is a kid I work with. This is when he was down in Orlando. Right, day one, he got all tournament. And my wife donated to the cause. So she donated an original.
Here's the card and all their stuff, but she donated this and this. So dollar a ticket.
Okay.
Somebody walked in and said, hey, here's $1,000. I'd be like, oh, that's what we need. But, you know, you take the good no matter what.
Don't get discouraged. I went through the same thing. I didn't make varsity my junior year. This whole summer, have a ball in your hand every day. Improve. And the people that push themselves generally achieve. So just keep going.
This one, called it Daddy Long Legs. He would play with the girls. After he got home from work, he'd change and play with the girls, and they'd climb all over his long legs. This was gopher hunting, teaching the girls to shoot. And I'm the good shot, by the way. This was it. This was at my aunt's house. It was the first or second time he ever came over. And I knew right away. We just worked. I told him straight out, don't ever tell me to shut up and don't ever call me the B word. And if you can't handle that, get out now. And we've just worked. I don't know. I love him. We live and breathe for him. And he does for us. So.
So if I'm coming out aggressive, you're...
No, it's not loose yet. I've got a little bit of a stomach muscle that's been irritating me a little bit. Another thing on my plate, my dad. He was in the hospital for 2 days in ICU.
Getting a pneumonia. Spent the last 8 days in the hospital.
Get it to me. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
His kidney transplant that he's had for 26 years has begun to fail.
With all of his basketball and everything that's going on, he's also going to get tested for compatibility for a kidney for me.
Ryan telling him all these things about because of what's going on with his dad. You know, if he needs to cancel the trip, he doesn't need to worry. He won't be mad. And I said, well, he wouldn't do that, and his dad probably wouldn't let him.
I can live. Like I say, I can live on dialysis, so I don't want to stop his dream.
If you feel in your heart that you can do something, I feel you can achieve it.
Blair has been training with hopes of getting a shot to play pro ball, and this weekend he will get a chance to impress coaches and scouts from over 25 different countries. The 2014 Las Vegas Overseas Basketball Combine begins this Friday and runs through Sunday. Reporting in Hamilton, Brad Pierce, NBC Montana.
I guess you have to earn your way through Sunday. If you don't do well Friday and Saturday, then you don't get invited to Sunday. I had one guy ask me what I thought my percentage of making it would be. I told him, you know, 100%, I'm gonna make it and get a contract out of here. And he said, man, I like your attitude. He said, that's the right answer. So, you know, I'm just gonna keep that attitude and see where it can get me. A little bit too much going on than I'm used to. Well, like I say, I normally go into a store and they got one or two pair I get to pick from, so.
Yeah, we normally only get like one size fits in.
I found a pair of Jordans and a pair of Chris Pauls. We'll have enough money for down here though. That's why I'm running it by you. Tell me what you think. Value your opinion on it, so.
Las Vegas, Nevada, baby.
Holy cow. This is big time for us, you know?
Oh, yeah. A little different than Montana. Mm-hmm. Missoula, what do you get?
Outback Steakhouse. That's the big leagues, baby.
Travis Nelson. I played overseas for 4 years. I was in the Czech Republic last year, Division II All-American. I played against him a little bit. He can shoot mid-range. He blocks shots. He's got good post-game. He's just got to keep working, man, you know? All it's going to take is one possession, one game, you know, here for a coach to see him and sign him.
Nervous.
Six, seven, eight, next, let's go, next. Let's go. You dunk that. You got to dunk that. You got to dunk that, big boy.
And it might not look pretty right now, but it'll come around.
Hold up, James. Can you shoot? Come on, fellas. Y'all got to make this. Y'all trying to live a dream.
He definitely is lacking some of that experience, structure. The thing is, though, the guy adapts like a chameleon.
Go. Go.
This guy wants it so bad.
Yeah. What I liked about him down in Miami, he was by far the toughest player out there. That night, his ankle was so swollen, he slept with his shoe on. And that's why I fell in love with him.
Yeah. Give him the ball. Look for him. Look for him. Right there. There you go. Yeah. Yeah. He'll make it. There ain't no question in my mind he won't make it. He'll make Sunday. I know he will.
This year, there's probably a good 40 to 45 of you guys that can play overseas or somewhere.
I've got something written down, probably about 50% of you so far, just from last night.
You gotta understand, you're trying to take a grown man's job. For you to make the team, you sending another dude home to his wife and kids to say, sorry, I ain't got no job. I gotta go back to school and finish my degree. So if you ain't treating it like such, don't expect that it's gonna work out for you.
He's gotta turn it on, man. You got about six scouts from around the world sitting at this game right now. Good, baby. Fucking God damn it. Ugh. Man. He's feeling something with his muscle issue with his stomach. Curious to see what's going on.
It felt like he got stabbed with a knife.
Like a pop?
You could feel, it felt like a tear.
It's a teared muscle, dude.
I'm not giving up because of it. I'm a little irritated with it because I hate being hurt. There it is.
He's going to need to come in and be flawless. He needs to be a professional basketball player today. His dad stopped breathing last night at 11 o'clock and is in St. Pat's Hospital as we speak. Lost 4 pints, almost bled out. His dad's okay. He's hooked up to a bunch of machines. I said, Shad, what do you think your dad thinks of you coming down here and doing this? What do you think? And I could see he was fighting tears. He just stared at me. He says, my dad wouldn't want me anywhere else but here.
Defensively, there was no problem. He was at the rim every time.
He has a big energy. Trust me, he was the best one on defense. You know? Like, he's fighting, he's touching all the ball after rebound, you know? It was good. Trust me, it was the best on especially defense.
But offensively, it was more of I want to move the ball and set the screen and pick and roll. Well, that's not going to get you signed, so.
Come on, Chad.
You see, Melvin Oliver played for Seton Hall. He's 7'1", 300 pounds. And he went at that guy. He went at him. But he just didn't have that finish like he should. I started to kind of question, is he at the top of the crop right now? And I didn't see, he was starting to blend in with players. You don't want to blend in.
36 years old, plumber, out here busting his butt. No matter what, I'm proud of him.
I just know he's not ready to be done, and I'm not ready for him to be done.
Goes down to the combine, comes back. He's kind of down and out with this whole basketball thing.
The dreams don't always put food on the table for the kids, and you know, in every amount of money you spend out of your normal budget, you know, that's gonna take some time to make up.
We're paying our bills. May not always be on time, but we're paying them. I want him happy, and basketball makes him happy. And he's a family man and provides for his family, and family comes first. And if anybody sitting there thinks that he's not putting his family first because we don't have the nicest house or we don't have brand new vehicles, I'm the wealthiest woman I know.
I felt like I failed him in a way. I wanted him to go down and I wanted everything to work out, you know, smoothly, and it didn't. Throughout this time, I've been thinking, you know, am I misleading this guy? Am I? There would be occasional doubts in my brain. I had a heart-to-heart with him saying, you know, look, I don't want to mislead you. You know, I don't want you to be thinking, you know, I'm going to be doing this forever. We got to, you know, set a deadline, and he was bummed out. Because the guy that really had been believing in him this whole time was kind of saying, hey, look, it might not work out.
some resource at the combine. I don't know exactly who was talking or where it came from, but then the email came calling Shad. I said, dude, what are you doing? Well, just hanging out working, installing this such and such at this house, you know, doing his plumbing stuff. And I said, you got a second? Yeah, what's going on? Well, you have a team interested in you. Gets all quiet on the phone. Really? Dude, team in Atlanta, ABA.
There he is. There he is.
Wildcats over the flight.
Get him in the pay, baby.
And we go inside on the block there. And a nice two for the Wildcats by Shad Blair.
With the Atlanta phone call, came out of the blue, and we had like 2 days. And I was not going to let him pass it up. We were going to sell stuff or whatever we had to do. I was not going to give another guy a free ride.
Get up, baby.
Oh, nice block by Blair there.
Finished that layup because Blair was made his presence known.
Go for it. Cut loose. What do you have to lose? Well, in his situation, a lot.
The flight who have it, and they've got an easy shot on the inside. It's shot away there by Blair. Big time defense, Brian.
Get it.
Shad Blair, 6'10", 205 out of Eastfield Junior College. And a resident of Stevensville, Montana.
Well, you see the replay. What looks like an easy basket was not. Blair hustles back to make a great block. Talk about
he was on TV. That's one goal down. I knew he'd do it. He's so strong. ESPN.
But who made that play was Shad Blair, and the fact that he hustled. Anytime you got your big guy that's able to make that transition and get back, puts a lot of pressure on the offense. Flight not being able to finish that layup because Blair was made his presence known.
And the alley-oop attempt went awry, but still it bounced back. Nice little bounce to Faust, and he was able to put it up for the deuce. And back to a 13-point lead for the Wildcats, 72-59.
Nice pass.
Easy on the inside there. And Belt with another two. He's got 13.